Hey, Margie. Happy 90th birthday. I just want to tell you, you're one of the most important people, one of the people that have made the most impact on my life. Next to my foster mother, I would say that you are the best example of a Christian woman and mother. Thank you for showing me how to cook and helping me to learn to love your son. I appreciate the wisdom and the fun times that we've had together. I think of one, which wasn't too much fun for me, but I appreciate how you stayed with me during my labor and delivery for, I think it was Ryan. All I remember is after 36 hours of labor, and they moved me over to the hospital, the one thing that I cried for was my mother-in-law. Not too many women can say that going into the labor and delivery room, they were calling for their mother-in-law. I thank you so much for all that you've done for me and for all the people that you have served, especially your children. You have been such a great example to me of someone who gives of their time, their energies, and their heart to their family. Love you, Margie.
Happy birthday, Meemaw, from the beach. Beautiful day. Happy 90th. Eli said, happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Hey, Mom, I'm terrible at doing these videos, so I can only imagine what this will look like. But I wanted to record something about special times, and I thought that I would bring up a striking video, a comfort, or excuse me, a striking memory, a comforting memory, an international memory, and then an eternal memory. So, the striking memory, of course, is you know that I always tended to have those snakes around that you didn't like. And I remember back when I was about 7 years old and we were baling hay out at Grandpa's, and Gary found that 4 or 5 foot black snake, and he gave it to me to put behind my back and take in to scare the ladies that were in the old farmhouse. Of course, that's one of the snake stories, and then the second would be the one where I had the pet garter snake that got loose in the house. And even though you were petrified of snakes, you allowed me to have that snake, and then you had nightmares for years afterwards about what happened to the snake that got loose in the house. A comfort memory, of course, was any time I would come home from school or from Maryland or Virginia, that you would always make the comfort foods, the special things, whether it was cream chicken sandwiches or raisin-filled cookies or ham loaf. And that was always very comforting to come home and know that I was going to be able to be treated with some of the special foods that had fond memories. The international memory was, of course, when we took the trip to Egypt and got exposed to some things that probably weren't what we hoped for a international family trip. Dustin cut his toe on the swimming pool the first day there, and of course we had Crazy Muhammad as our taxi driver who ran into somebody when we were going back to the hotel. And then we rode the train to Alexandria, and of course all of the backsheesh and bribery and stuff that goes on for people to carry your bags. And then we got to see lots of bowls that were buried down below in the sarcophaguses, and see some different cultural things that I know were different from your experience here. And of course, you riding a camel with Lindsay and then not being able to get off of the camel. So that's international memory. And then the eternal memory, of course, is the years that you led the choir at the church, you played the piano, and you sang so beautifully. And that's something that I'm always going to remember. And you're just a blessing to me, a wonderful mother. And thank you for all that you've done over 90 years of life. We love you. God bless you. And we hope to be able to see you many more times after this 90th birthday. Bye.
One, two, three.
Happy 90th birthday, Mima!
One, two, three.
Happy 90th birthday, Mima!
Love you! Love you! Kiss bye, kiss bye. Good.
Happy birthday, Mima. I'm so happy to have you in my life. And thank you for making some of the greatest memories that I have of my childhood. Walking downstairs to the kitchen early in the morning with the smell of chicken noodle, or hearing you playing the piano, and just hearing your laugh. And I consider myself extremely lucky to have you as my grandma. I love you.
One of my other favorite stories about Mima, or memories of Mima, is when she told me about how she went to the county fair to see Papa ride his horse. And she told me at the time she only had enough money for the bus ticket there. And they didn't know how she and her friend went. She didn't know how they were going to make it back. But she knew that she wanted to see Papa race his horse, his paint. So she made it out there, and she hitchhiked a ride home. And I thought, when I heard that story, like, Mima is one of the coolest hardcore chicks I've ever met, and I hope I can be as cool as her. Thanks, buddy. We wanted to tell you, happy 90th birthday, Mima. And thank you, Aunt Heather, for putting this together. Logan, can you look at the camera? Say hi. Ready? Say hi, Mima.
Wait, wait.
Okay, we're putting it in now. So, one of my favorite memories about Mima is cooking. We always did cooking together, and if you go to Mima's house, you know she's always gonna cook dinner. So Logan and I are baking brownies. Good job. Can you put the oil in? Good job using two hands. Ooh, does that look good? Is brownie batter your favorite? Wait, it's not ready yet.
Egg.
That is an egg. Can you show me how to crack it? Oh. Well, you live and you learn.
Uh-oh.
We dropped that egg.
That's okay.
It is on the floor and we will get it in a minute. Please do not put the eggshell in there. No.
Oh, gee. No.
Okay. No. Try again. Ready? Crack. Yeah. Good. One more. Yep. Okay. Now we're going to squeeze the egg. Ready? Ta-da.
Ta-da.
Good job. Good job, helper.
Happy 90th birthday, Mima. You're making me tired and falling asleep like you do. Happy 90th birthday, Mom. Thank you for loving us unconditionally and with all your heart.
Happy 90th birthday, Margaret. Hello, Margaret. It's your favorite son-in-law. Just in case you had to think about that, it's me, Aaron. Anyway, 90 years. What an awesome feat. I sit there and think, and since I'm so sports-related, I just wonder how many crazy sporting events or historical sporting events you've had the honor of being around for. But just want to say a couple things that come to mind of yours that I absolutely love. Of course, uniced cutouts. Yep. My favorite. Well, we'll say that's, I have two favorites. And then the pie crust. Now, I know that you always made that just for me. I just let other people like Beth have some. But anyway, yep. What a great, hope you have a wonderful day. And we love you and glad you're here for number 90 and we can share it with you.
Okay, Mom. We're in the Marg Mahal. Wondering where you're at because you're not here. But we're going to go through some things that have been some of the greatest memories of my life. So the first one would be our love for feather pillows and satin pillowcases. I appreciate you sewing all of that Velcro on those pillowcases for all the pillows that I've had and I've lost through the years. Second, we'll do the donuts for sleepovers. I loved, those were the best biscuit donuts ever, and you got to shake them in whatever bag you wanted. Next, we would have to go with my ironing skills definitely came from you. You always made us do iron Dad's handkerchiefs, then we had to do pillowcases, and then finally we graduated to t-shirts. Least favorite, never again. So, last but not least, I am thankful for the knowledge of how to announce Yahtzee. So anyhow, oh Gertie, that would be some of my fondest ones. And even though Aaron, we won't tell him, calls me MJ, Marg Jr., and I act like I don't like it, I really do, but don't tell him.
What you say? Happy 90th birthday, Mimo? Say, I'm in your bed. Happy birthday, Mimo.
Happy 90th birthday, Grandma.
Hi, Mimo. I just wanted to wish you happy birthday. I hope you have the best day ever. I just want you to know how much you're appreciated and how much I have loved being a part of your family the past 8 years. And I just want to thank you for letting me join your family with open arms. And my favorite thing is just every Sunday coming down, just sitting around the table talking, and just catching up on our lives and everything. And I just hope we can continue that tradition and, you know, years to come, and start doing it with Asher when he gets older and his family and this next baby. So I hope to keep on that legacy. And you know, I just want to thank you for everything you've done for me over the past few years, and I love you. Have a good day.
Happy birthday! It's a lunatic. Have a wonderful 90th birthday. We all wish you well and love you so much.
One of my biggest memories, Marg, of you was always working in the kitchen. No matter when I came, it seemed like you was either out there baking or cooking. And I must say, it was pretty good.
Mom, there's so many memories. It's hard to pick one or two to tell you. I would say you've taught me everything growing up, the rights and the wrongs and everything. And I remember you at church, we sat with Aunt Lily and Uncle RB while you directed the choir, always directing the choir and playing the piano. So that would be one of my memories from way back when. And there's many, many more, but you don't have the time to listen to them.
And we can't say them here.
So have a good birthday.
Happy birthday, Marg. A wonderful 90.
Happy birthday, Mom. Hope you have a great day and many more to come. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday,
Mimo.
Mimo. Happy.
Say love you. Hey.
Yeah.
You look here. Yeah. Tell Mimo, say love you.
Yeah. Happy. Birthday. Mimo. Tell her. Say happy birthday, Mimo.
Hi, Mimo.
Say love you. Give her a kiss. Look at the camera and give her a kiss. That's so cute.
Happy 90th birthday, Meemaw.
Hey, Graham. You know whose favorite color this is?
Guess whose?
Meemaw's. Grim, do you like when Meemaw would rock you as a baby and sing songs to you? Do you know what I remember? When I was little, Meemaw would go to the store and she would be gone for 2 to 3 hours. And I would ask Papa where she went to, and he would say Market Basket and Mako's, and she's probably just talking to people. And other memories I have of Meemaw is playing the piano. Do you know how to play the piano? Yeah. And you know what else? I remember when I came home when I was a senior and she was cleaning our windows for my graduation party. Alex, what's your favorite memory?
I remember Meemaw always sleeping at the table. That's how you knew it was a good party, if Meemaw fell asleep afterwards.
Happy birthday, Meemaw! Graham, whose birthday is it? Who's? Look at the camera.
Meemaw!
Meemaw's birthday!
heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord. But you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall and the major lift, the barefoot king composing hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Your faith was strong, but you needed proof. You saw her bathing on the roof, you know. Her beauty in the moonlight overthrew you. And then she tied you to her kitchen chair, and she broke your throat, she cut your hair, and from your lips she drew the hallelujah, 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 ooh, yeah. From love was how to shoot somebody who out you, yeah. It's not a cry that you hear at night, it's not someone who's seen the light, it's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. The only one.
hope someday you'll join us, and the world will be as one. Imagine there's no countries. It isn't hard to do. Nothing to kill or die for. No religion to. Imagine all the people living life in peace. You may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday the world will be as one. Imagine no possessions. I wonder if you can. No need for greed or hunger. A brotherhood of men. Imagine all the people sharing all the world. You and you may say I'm a dreamer, but I'm not the only one. I hope someday